The Mediterranean is overfished. From my childhood, you could see octopus out in the shore because there were many. Now there are very few. I hope it won't happen and it won't continue the pollution and all the wastes that are getting in the water, so our children will find something too.
There is a plan for 25% of Poros to become an organized agriculture zone. 1/4 of our island will be occupied by fish farms. EU and the UN, actually, they are promoting aquaculture as a sustainable form to combat overfishing. Aquaculture, especially on this scale, is destructive to the environment. It releases a lot of waste to the sea. And also it destroys the Posidonia meadows. They're very important for releasing oxygen to the atmosphere. And that's why they're protected species. In the area where the fish farms are, we have footage showing that everything is dead. It's like a moonscape.
Είναι κακή ιδέα γιατί το νησί είναι μικρό και δεν χωράει άλλα. Δηλαδή αυτά είναι ήδη αρκετά. Είναι ήδη αρκετά αυτά, οπότε δεν χωράει άλλα. Είναι μικρό το νησί. Δηλαδή οτιδήποτε παραπέρα θα είναι καταστροφή. Η βασική δουλειά μου εκεί ήταν συντήρηση των δικτυών. Αλλά μιλάμε τώρα για κλουβιά που έχει πάνω από 90.000 ψάρια μέσα. Γίνεται χαμός. Αφρίζει όλη η θάλασσα από πάνω όταν καταΐζουν. Είναι δύο ειδών τα ψάρια που συνήθως καλλιεργούν εδώ, το είναι το τσιπούρο και το λαβράκι. Αυτά που έχω δει εκεί, δηλαδή, που θα θεωρούνται, ας πούμε, κακά, είναι, ας πούμε, παραδείγματος χάρη το χρώμα που χρησιμοποιούσαν για να βάφουν τα δίχτυα, το οποίο η ουσία μέσα ήταν δηλητήριο, ήταν δηλαδή απαγορευμένη ουσία και αυτό μέσα εκεί μεγαλώνουν τα ψάρια, για να σας καταλάβετε. Μετά είναι και τις φορμόλες που χρησιμοποιούσαν, που κάνανε μπάνιο τα ψάρια μέσα στη θάλασσα και μετά όλο αυτό το υγρό πήγαινε μέσα στο νερό. Δεν νομίζω ότι τα ψάρια από το εξωτερικό είναι μια καλή αυτή για τροφή.
My relationship with the sea, it's a love affair. From when I was a child, I was going fishing with my father. He used to tell me that you could catch fish anywhere. Now you have to try and find fish. The expansion of the aqua farms will affect us very much because we won't know where to put our nets. We are going to have a great problem. You can't live from fishing because the money is very few, which is difficult. That's why I'm telling you that fishing in Greece is going to expire.
It's a multinational that owns the biggest part of fish farms in Greece in general and on Poros. There's no money coming back to either the local community or Greece. The problem is that we don't understand how they mean the sustainability term, because at least for carnivore aquaculture, which is what we have here in Greece, the wild fish that is used for the fish meal that is fed to the cultivated fish is 1.2 to 1. So that means that we kill more wild fish to feed the fish that we produce. And actually they take these wild fish from Africa and from places that, you know, they deplete their income and their food source in order to produce more expensive fish to feed the north and the developed countries. The European Union should work more on defining what sustainable aquaculture is. We have to think very well about what we consume, in what quantities, where this our food is resourced. I think it's like a couple of decades, 10, 15 years ago with the meat industry, when everybody suddenly realized how bad it is for the environment. The food that was created by the meat industry was not healthy for consumption. And then we turned our sights to the sea to find the solution for protein consumption to the sea. The problem is everything that is extreme is bad for our health and for the environment, and this is what is happening now with the aquaculture. It's being developed in an extreme scale. It is not a solution, it's another problem.